Hey guys, Omarr here with the iPad Pro and an Apple Pencil. So today I'm just going to show you the basics of how to use the pencil. Obviously, when it's all paired up, check out my previous videos in this playlist and I'll show you how to obviously pair it up and any troubleshooting that you may come across.
Before I forget, subscribe and also hit the bell icon to be notified of any new videos that I post.
So just talking you through the notes application itself, this button here allows you to add people. So essentially, if you're working on something, you can share and they can add and annotate and things like that. So obviously this is the bin, so when you want to scrap a note, you can go and share it here. So that's also an option, and obviously that's a new page there. On the bottom, if you select this icon here, you'll see that you'll be able to get your tools. So obviously you've got like some different types of writing tools. So you've got like a pen type of tool here. You can turn this down to change how opaque the ink is. So you can have a really dark and a really light and things like that. You can have it, obviously it's you know, depending on how hard you touch the pencil to the screen, the thicker the actual lines will be. But you also have an option here of changing how the pen will interact like that. So you can do highlights as well, so you can change the colors onto that and the actual sort of tip part on the screen will change to that color. So for example, you could have a green pen, but then you'd know that you got a blue highlight right there, which is good as well. Obviously pen, same thing, you can change it so it's very soft, or you could change it so it's very hard, and things like that. So then this is the eraser. So you have an option here of tapping the side like so, and you can switch back, as you can see from the bottom, you can switch back from the pen to the eraser. Now I've set this in the settings. So for example, if I go into the settings, go down into Apple Pencil, and you can basically set it here where you can switch between the current tool and the eraser, the current tool and the last used, and you can show the color palette, and obviously you have an off option, and that is incredibly useful whenever you're sort of made a mistake. You can go back, it doesn't sort of erase a little bit. So for example, this stroke here, if I was to erase this, it would erase all of it like that, but it's still useful. So if you were sort of sketching, you'd make little sketches like this, little strokes even, like this. And then if you was to erase, you could just erase a little bit. So that would be the technique that you'd use. Now this is just the sort of tool that you can grab a load of stuff. You can move it around. It's quite intuitive like that. Obviously these are the colors. You can't change these colors. So if I was to hold down this black here, I can't change it for anything else. So these are the quick sort of colors that you have, and you're stuck with them. You can't change them. You can go into the color wheel and change, for example, you know, to different shades of whatever color, and then that stays there, and then you can use another one for, you know, this particular highlighter, and another one. So you can sort of save colors like that, but you can't actually change it, which is a shame, because that would have been quite useful. Essentially, once you're done, you can then go back into your notes, save them, and essentially just share them or whatever you want to do there. The one interesting thing is that if you've got kids, you can now sort of download free sort of coloring. So with the new feature of markup. So markup is essentially when you download a picture of any sort, you can annotate it. Now when you do that, for example, I've downloaded this sort of free coloring page for my nephew and stuff. And what you can do is you can select it and then select the pen here, and then use this, and you know, you could give it to your kids, they could color, they could do whatever they want to do. You can, if you hit the plus sign here, you can add text to it, you can type and stuff, you can add a signature, magnify, so you can magnify and grab with the pen, grab with your finger. It doesn't work with the pencil, but you can magnify with your finger and you know, bring a certain area closer, so you can, I guess, color you know, things like that. And then it just gives you more flexibility with coloring, saving. You've got, you can annotate, add arrows there, speech bubbles, all that good stuff. And then obviously you can, when you hit done, it saves in the notes, and you can share the note to whoever via email or, you know, AirDrop or whatever. So that was just a quick look and really a basics of what you can do with the Apple Pencil on the iPad Pro, this year's 2018 iPad Pro. Thanks for watching, guys. Do have a look at other videos in this playlist, and I'll see you in the next one.